Hello students, so in today class we discuss YouTube differential manometers, the definitions and construction and also working principle of differential manometers. So first point, we understand meaning of the differential manometers, that is statement of a definition statement. So manometers, the devices which are used for measuring the pressure difference between two points in a pipe is called YouTube differential manometers. What is manometers? The manometers which you use for measuring pressure difference between two points in a pipe. So for example, let us consider a pipe. This is one pipe in which some liquid is flowing. So water or kerosene, oil or any fluid. So here this is a point number A and this is point number B, second point. So if you fix a manometer between these two for measuring the pressure difference between A and B, that is PA minus PB is a pressure difference. So such type of manometers will be used for measuring pressure difference between two points in a single pipe. Here is a single pipe. And only there is only one liquid. There is no two liquids. There is one liquid, that is water or kerosene. Let us take water is flowing through this pipe. So YouTube differential manometer also be used for measuring pressure difference between two pipes. For example, here is a one pipe, pipe A. Okay, here liquid is flowing. Let us consider oil. There is another pipe, B. Here liquid is, water is flowing through this pipe. Let us consider water. So you need to measure the pressure difference between these two. Then you use a YouTube differential manometer. You connect one YouTube differential manometer between these two pipes. Then you can measure the pressure difference easily between these two pipes. That is the applications of YouTube differential manometers. Now we will consider how to write the expression for this YouTube differential manometers. There are two different cases will come into the picture. One is point A and point B, both are on the same level here. Both are on the same level from the ground at a distance of h. Point A is also at a distance of h from the reference line, and as well as point B is also same height from the reference line. But in the industry, it is not constant always. One pipe will be here, one more pipe will be here. Between these two, we need to measure the pressure difference using such type of manometers. So that is our case number two. Okay, this is a pipe A and this is a pipe B. There is a difference in height between pipe A and pipe B. Understood? So this is a different case. It's also called a YouTube differential manometer, but case different, type number two. Okay, here pipe A and pipe B, both are on the same level, same height from the ground. Here pipe A is ahead of pipe B. It is little bit height than from pipe number B, that is H. So I will consider one, we'll take one picture and we'll derive an expression for YouTube differential manometer for both cases. Here I have taken two different pipes. So for example, here is a pipe A. Here in the pipe A, liquid is flowing. Let us consider liquid A, whatever may be the liquid. It may be water or diesel, whatever may be, liquid A. And the density of this liquid is rho 1. Specific gravity of this liquid is S. Okay, these are the notations. And H is a height of liquid A in the left limb. This is called left limb. This portion we will call it as limb, or it is also called as column. Limb or column. Left column, left limb. And this is called as right limb or right column. In some different books use the word limb, some books they use the word column, or some books they use the word tube. That is also correct. There is no wrong in that. So H1 is a height of liquid A, in the left limb. H3 is a height of mercury in the right limb. H3 is height of liquid, that is mercury, in the right limb. H2 is height of liquid 2, that is in the second pipe, liquid B, I will consider it as liquid B. So rho 2 is a density of the liquid B, and S is a specific gravity of the liquid B. Why we need S means for solving some numericals, we need density. In numericals, he used specific gravity. Instead of giving density, he gives specific gravity, that is S. So using specific gravity, we will calculate density. If density is given in the numerical, it is easy. No issues at all. So we must remember the both properties, density as well as specific gravity. What is definition of the specific gravity? Specific gravity is defined as a ratio of density of the fluid or liquid, the given liquid, divided by density of the standard liquid, that is water. So standard density of water is, that is 1000. This is the value of density of water. So this specific gravity will be given in the numerical, 0.85, 0.95, 0.75, like that. So this will be given, specific gravity, density of water we know. So cross multiply these two to calculate density of the given liquid which is flowing through the pipe. Understood? Okay. Now, one more point you need to remember here is the type of manometric fluid. Manometric fluid is a fluid which is chosen, which are taken inside the manometer. So inside the manometer, we have taken mercury, that is Hg. So rho 3 is a density of the mercury. Rho 3 is density of the mercury, or specific gravity of the mercury is S. Okay. Anyway, the standard density of the mercury is 13,600, that we know. But in general, we have written rho 1, rho 2, and rho 3. Okay. So here we will note down in different ways. So H1, H3 is height of mercury. I will write here. Height of mercury in the right limb. What is H2? Height of liquid B. Whatever may be the liquid. Liquid B in right column. Right column. Here it is H2. And what is H1? H1 is height of liquid in the left column. Here we will write it, densities. Rho 1 is the density of the fluid in the liquid A. Rho 1 is density of the liquid A. What is rho 2? Density of liquid B. What is rho 3? Rho 3 is density of the mercury. Because these are the six notations we need for solving numericals. Okay. Now, we will write an expression. Okay. So now I will start writing the expression from this point. Okay. From this point, I will write. So let us discuss PA. PA is a pressure in the left column or left pipe number A. PA is a pressure. Now pressure due to this horizontal fluid is not considered. Always pressure is equal to P is equal to rho ZH according to hydrostatic law. So pressure is depends on height of the liquid. So here is a horizontal length is there. So you not consider the pressure due to horizontal column, okay, horizontal fluid. So now I will come from this point to this point up below the reference line up to here, okay. And dear students, xx is called reference line, and you have to choose the reference line xx in such a way that below the reference line there must be only manometric fluid, that is mercury. If you have chosen mercury as a manometric fluid, below the reference line there must be only mercury. Above the reference line, it is whatever may be the liquids, water, kerosene, or combination, everything. So now I am moving from this point to this point. So what is the height from this point to this point? That is H1. H1 is the height. Now you apply this formula, pressure formula for this height. P is equal to, okay. Now I'm coming in the downward direction. So I will take it as positive. So what is the density in the left column? That is rho 1. So rho 1 is a density in the right left column. G value is standard, right? G value. What is H? H1 is a height of the fluid in the left column. Okay. This is equation number 1. You can take this is equation number 1. Now, similarly, you write expression for right column. So what is the pressure in the pipe B? The pressure in the pipe B is PB. I will write it as PB. plus. Now pressure due to this horizontal fluid is not considered, it is neglected. Okay, so what is the liquid in the pipe right limb? From here to here it is a liquid. What is the height of the liquid? That is h2. So height is h2. What is the density of the liquid in the right limb here in this region? That is rho2. Rho2 is a density. And g as it is. What is the height? h2. Is there any other fluid in the right limb? Yes, there is mercury liquid is there. So we cannot neglect the pressure due to this mercury also, because it is above the reference line. Above the reference line it is there. So h3 is the height of the mercury from this point to this point. So plus rho3 is a density, g value. So h3 is a height of the mercury. So this is equation number 2. So now equate equation number 1 is equal to equation number 2, because it is a after equilibrium. After equilibrium, it will be both pressure should be same and same. So for that reason, so what will write equation number 1 is equal to equation number 2. So I will write here after equilibrium, equation number 1 is equal to equation number 2. So write equation number 1 PA plus rho 1 GH1. Equation number 2 is PB plus rho 2 is the density of the liquid in the second pipe. G is a value of 9.81. H2 is the height of liquid B in the second pipe, that right column, plus rho 3 GH3. And students, now here we need a pressure difference between PA and PB. So you take PA minus PB is equal to, right as it is, rho 2 GH2 plus rho 3 GH3 as it is. So these three terms you take on the right hand side, rho 1 GH1. So this is a formula, an equation for calculating pressure difference between two points or between two pipes using U-tube differential manometer. Similarly, we will write an expression for the other types, that is both PA and PB are on the same level. So let me take a copy. I will draw the diagram here. Okay, here is a, for this diagram we will write now. For the second case, both A and B are on the same level. A and B are nothing but pipe A and pipe B, both are on the same level from the ground. Again, how to write in the exam is, consider a U-tube differential manometer. One end of the manometer is connected to pipe A, in which some liquid is flowing. So what is a liquid? Liquid A. Density of the liquid A is rho 1. Specific gravity of the liquid is S. And another end of the manometer is connected to pipe B, in which liquid is flowing. That what type of liquid? Liquid B, some other liquid. Liquid B. And the density of the liquid B is rho 2. S is a specific gravity at S2. Here it is S1. Okay. S1 stands for specific gravity of the liquid A. S2 stands for specific gravity of the liquid B. And we have taken a standard manometric fluid, that is mercury. Rho 3 is a density of the mercury. And S3 is a specific gravity of the mercury, that is Hg. And I need to tell you one point is, you remember, the density of the manometric fluid, whichever may be the manometric fluid you are choosing here, I have taken mercury here, whichever may be the fluid, the density of the manometric fluid should be more than density of the fluids which is flowing through the pipe A and B. What does it mean? Rho 3 should be more than density of the fluid or liquid flowing in a pipe A or as well as B. This is a point you need to remember in the U-tube differential manometer. Very important point. There is another type of differential manometer, that is inverted U-tube differential manometer. That is reverse. There the density of the manometric fluid will be less than the density of the liquids flowing in the pipe A and B. Okay. So here density of manometric fluid is more in this case. Now, dear students, now you will write an expression for this diagram, the second diagram. So what is, again, you will have to choose the height. Okay, height of liquid in the pipe A as well as height of liquid in the pipe B. So what is the height of liquid in the pipe A? That is H1. H1 is height of liquid in the left limb by the liquid A. This liquid is same as the pipe A liquid. Okay. So H2 is height of liquid in the right column. Which liquid? Liquid B. Liquid B height is H2. What is H3? H3 is height of mercury in the right column. Understood? These are the two heights. Okay, now we will write the expression here only. Now you are at this point. You start writing the pressure equation. PA plus pressure due to this horizontal fluid is neglected. So only we need to consider vertical fluid, vertical liquid, vertical the water, whatever may be the fluid. So what is the general expression? P is equal to rho z h. So for this height h1, what is the pressure? H1, what is the pressure? That is rho 1. Instead of rho, I will write rho 1 because we are writing for liquid A. G as it is, height is h1. So is there any fluid in the left column here? Is there any fluid in the left column other than this height? No, there is no fluids in the left column. Only liquid A is there. So you go to second right limb. So this is equation number 1. So second column, that is right limb. So PB is a pressure in the pipe B. So PB plus write the expression for pressure due to this height of fluid from H2. So the rho 2 is the density of the liquid B, G is a gravitational force, and H2 is a height. So plus value, because here we are considering from here to here. So pressure due to this height is again rho GH. Rho 3 is the density of the liquid, that is mercury. G is a value as it is, H3. This is equation number 2. Now at equilibrium condition, so at equilibrium condition, at equilibrium condition, equation number 1 is equal to equation number 2. So what is equation number 1? I will write equation number 1 here. So PA plus rho 1 GH1 is equal to PB plus rho 2 GH2 plus rho 3 GH3. So we need a pressure difference between these two. So PA minus PB is equal to, it's the remaining equation as it is. So in this case, only the value of H1, H2, H3 will be different. Otherwise, the remaining, the equation remains same, like both are on different levels. Equation is remain same. The only the value of height in the liquid left limb, right limb will change. Okay. So these are the one method to write the expressions. My dear students, so what will happen if you have such type of fluids, like that, for example, this is one U-tube. In one U-tube, this is a one U-tube. Another inverted U-tube manometers. This is one U-tube. One more U-tube manometers. So we cannot write equation number 1, equation number 2, equation number 3, because we cannot divide it is left, which one is a left limb, which one is a right limb. If, for example, if we consider this is a section, so these two will become the left limb and these two will become the right limb. So it will be very difficult for writing a pressure equation. So in such case, what you need to do is, instead of writing two equations or three equations, we can write only a single equation. That hint I will give how to write. Okay, for writing that equation, I will consider this diagram, because anyway some annotations are there on this. I will consider this diagram for writing the equation. So I will take different colors so that it will become easy for writing an expression for it. So let me take the blue one. Okay, so how will we explain the construction of this? Here pipe A and pipe B, both are not on the same level because there is a height of X difference between A and B. Means pipe A is here, here liquid A, some water is flowing. Pipe B is somewhere here. Both are not on the same height. So if there is a manometer is connected between these two. So this is the diagram we have taken here. Here is a ground. Let us consider here is a ground. This is the center of the pipe B. It is height of X. And here is the height of Y. So X minus Y is one more X. That X you have taken here. Okay, this is only for understanding purpose. So when you are solving numericals, he will give the difference in height between the two pipes and all. Don't worry. First, you need to understand how to write the expression. So liquid A is in the pipe BA. Liquid B is in the pipe B. Density of the liquid A is rho 1. Specific gravity of the liquid A is S1. Density of the liquid B is rho 2. Specific gravity of the liquid is S2 in the pipe B. And the type of manometer we have chosen here is mercury. What is the density of the mercury here? That is rho 3. And what is the specific gravity? S3. And dear listeners, there is no rule that rho 1 is always for liquid A, rho 2 is always for liquid B, and similarly 3 for mercury. You can change the notation, depends upon your requirements. You can take one, two, or three notations for different fluids. That is not a mandatory. Okay. Now I will write then simple, only one equation. Instead of writing one, two equations and writing equilibrium, I will write only one equation. So you start from writing this point. This is pressure at A. So first you write pressure at A. Now the pressure due to this horizontal fluid, horizontal pipe is neglected. Now you are start from writing this point to this point. So let us consider height is H1. What is H1? H1 is height of liquid A in the left limb. This is called left limb. So pressure due to this height is, so you are taking, you are coming downward. You are writing, presently you are standing this point. You are coming in the downward direction. So downward direction, you take it is positive. You can take it negative also, but other direction, when you are going upward, you take minus. Okay. So no problem. Here I have taken positive. So pressure due to height H1 is rho 1, density of the liquid A, because in this limb, in this column, liquid A is there. So rho 1, G, H1 is a height. Now you are at this point. Now I will not consider the pressure below the reference line. Because below the reference line, there is only one liquid, that is mercury. Height of this liquid from here to here, height of this liquid from here to here, both are same in different limbs. So it gets cancelled. Once you write the equation, one left hand side you are taking positive, right hand side you will take the negative. So plus and minus both get cancelled. So you will not consider pressure below the reference line. Understood? So below the reference line, now so you are going, now you are at this point. You are considering the pressure of the height of mercury in this right limb or right column. What is the height? H3 is the height of the mercury. What is the pressure? H3 is height. Here also I will write. So now you are going in the upward direction. You are considering the upward direction. So I will take minus because a plus I have taken in the downward direction. Minus is for upward direction. So plus is for downward direction. Minus is for upward direction. So what is the height? Height is H3. So pressure due to height H3, rho 2, rho 3 is the density of the mercury. That is rho 3. G is as it is. H3 is the height. Now you are at this point. Now what is the height of liquid B in the right limb from here to here? That is H2. Density is rho 2. Again, you are going upward. You are measuring pressure in the upward direction. You are going from down to top, from bottom to top. So here minus, that is rho 2 is a density, G value, and H2 is a height. Now we are at this point. Now pressure due to this horizontal fluid is not considered because always pressure is depends on height of the column, height of the liquid. So I will not write any pressure equation for horizontal fluid, for this fluid. I will not write. So here is a pressure pipe B. So you can write minus PB is equal to zero. So this is equation is same as the equation what you have written in the before for type 2 just before. So just you copy this equation. I will copy this so I will, it will become easy for me to compare. Here, my dear students, look this equation. Okay, so this equation is same as this equation. Let me copy. Okay, so this is not there. Let me copy this equation. So this equation is same as the equation what you have written in the turn here. Both are same. Okay. But this equation we have written by taking equation 1 and equation 2. But this is another way of writing the equation directly. So in the next session, we will start numericals on YouTube differential manometers. So thank you for watching this video.